Hello, Mr. Vardarajan, and welcome to One Teacher, One Scientist chat room. It's such a pleasure to have you here with you with your illustrious career in teaching, heading institutions, being on the panel of NCERT, and being the principal of such a prestigious school in Vadodara. I am greatly honored to have you on our chat room. And today I would like to have your insights on what should be the aim and purpose of education. I've always believed that every child is born with his own natural intelligence, and the purpose and role of education should actually be to help the child unleash that inner potential that he is born with. What are your thoughts on this, sir?
Thank you, Madam Vaishali. I must thank you for the wonderful words you spoke about me. I think you have taken the right step in trying to view education from a new paradigm. I think I should appreciate you for that.
Thank you, sir.
To me, it appears that no person born in this world is an absolute clean slate. This means students coming to the school are not clean slates.
Absolutely.
I normally call teaching as a cooperative art. Teaching like farming is a cooperative art. For the wonderful words said about me. Teaching like farming is a cooperative art. Building like shoemaking is a contrastive art. You might ask me what's a cooperative art and what's a contrastive art. Cooperative art is one which involves working along with nature and facilitating what nature by itself can do to grow and develop. For example, even if there are no farmers, you will have vegetation. Lots of vegetation down there if there are no farmers. Similarly, even if there are no teachers, lot of education could take place. We have lots of examples in our history, in our legend, in our literature, everywhere. Many people who became scholars, who became wonderful people without going to any schooling at all. That's why Mark Twain once said, schooling should not be allowed to interfere with education. Schooling and education should not be confused. A contrastive art is one where the person does something on his own without any involvement of nature. For example, if there is no mason, you cannot erect a wall. If there is no shoemaker, you cannot have shoes.
Yes.
So, we as teachers, we belong to the complementary art. And one thing we must understand, you see, the child who is coming to school is not a clean slate. It's not a clean slate. All living things, when they are born with an inherent portion. Right? And the success of us lies primarily in how do we catch the inherent portion. I always say, schooling is to the youngsters like faceting is to the diamond.
Correct.
Am I right?
Yes, absolutely, sir.
A diamond becomes a diamond. A diamond has got the ability of glittering in itself. When you mine a diamond, probably the diamond and the gold will not have any difference at all. But when you facet the diamond, the diamond becomes wonderful, precious gem.
Absolutely.
But you cannot facet a coal and make it into a jam.
Yeah.
So faceting is only facilitating, making the thing to get the entire potential of it. A student who comes to the school, a student in the contemporary time, or the formerly, let's say, in the past, you see, take the Mahabharata time. Dronachari was a wonderful teacher. He was a wonderful teacher, not because he taught the princes of 99 Kauravas and 5 Pandavas, but because Dronachari was able to identify the archer in Arjuna and the clubbist in Bhimasena. So obviously he put the bow in the hands of Arjuna and the club in the hands of Bhima. Had Dronachari not got to know the inherent potential, it's called the innate quality of Arjuna and Bhima, probably you would have put a bow in the hand of Bhimasena and the club in the hands of Arjuna. Of course, they would have used it. Bhimasena also used to use bows, and Arjuna was also capable of wielding a bow, wielding a club. But the difference is the superior, the superb archer that Arjuna was would not have been there. So the success of Dronacharya, we call him a great teacher, primarily because he was able to identify the innate quality. In fact, life itself is like that. What is education after all? If a person is educated, we always say men are born alike. All of us are born alike. Yes. But when by education we become different. What does education do? The education helps us to grip that basic potential in us, our positive pattern in that, and flourish it. Yes. So here if you see, human beings have instinct for learning, whereas animals have instinct as learning. For example, a bee has the instinct, is born with the instinct of making a hive. They say the beehive is the best of all civil construction.
Absolutely.
Right? A bird is born with a basic instinct to make a nest. But among human beings, for example, we all are born with instincts. We all born with instinct to learn, but it depends on the teacher. That's why you always say a teacher cannot be displaced. It depends upon the teacher who is able to identify the basic instinct, basic plus factor in me, and help me to capitalize it. One plus factor which has come out of it is, both by way of feedback from the parents as well as from the students, is, sir, online classroom teaching is okay, but somehow we feel that the transaction, the end product, the result is not the same as it would be if the students were in the class. So
what do you think should be the role of a teacher?
Tell me, ma'am.
No, I just want to know what in today's times should be the role of a teacher.
Teaching is not telling, that we should understand. If teaching is telling, then the computer is the best teacher. The role of a teacher today is not providing information. Dissemination of data is not the role of a teacher. Let's be very clear about it.
Absolutely.
The teaching is not telling what the student has to do. Teaching is facilitating the students to know what he wants, know where he will get what he wants.
Absolutely.
And above all, know how to use it after he gets it. That's the most important thing.
Yes.
You may want an AK-46 to get it, but if you don't know how to use it, probably you will be jeopardizing your life.
Yes.
The role of the teacher today is to grip that, the grip that he in every student. Every student, I always say, all of us are born to become great. Every one of us have got that basic potential.
Absolutely.
I don't basically believe in writing off students as they is useless, he cannot do anything. Every one of us, the student who miserably fails in the annual examination also has got some plus factor in him. The large scale operation with a population of about 1.3 billion, 130 crores.
Absolutely.
And the younger India is quite young.
Yeah.
The population is, the people who are going to the school and the colleges and universities, is humongous in India. Obviously, when Dronachari was able to teach about 100 students in his ashram without any other disturbance, obviously Dronachari did have a lot of time to prospect his student. Now, when you prospect a student, you find out where his strength lies, where his weakness lies. Right? Now, in the Dronachari in the past, he had less students, but we have a plus factor now is we have wonderful technology available with us, with which we will be able to study and scan our students. And one thing which, as a principle, education is not filling an empty vessel, but kindling a fire.
Absolutely.
You are not.
Absolutely. So I think we all need to reinvent the way we are looking at education.
Yes. Yeah.
And
yes,
make it more meaningful for a child and help him transform internally. So somewhere education has to be looked from within outwards, like, you know, coming from within and making an outward, helping a child to experience the world around him.
Absolutely right, madam. If we are not able to change our style, probably in another 5 years or 10 years, we will be out of job. Because what is expected today is not a dissemination of information, but facilitating the evolution of human beings into humane individuals. The aptitude, the priorities of the buyer, the market changes. Now, if at all the education system has to change now, what are our priorities? Both from the point of view of the parents,
yes,
as well as the students.
Yes.
One thing which we fail to understand is we should not equate schooling or education with career making. Career making is one aspect. Probably education, a byproduct of education, could be you become more employable. But if you fix education, the entire purpose, the entire object of education, the entire object of schooling is to make us to churn out more and more employable people. That is where the problem lies.
Absolutely.
So it's like the twin blades of a pair of scissors. If a scissor has to work effectively, both the blades of the scissor will have to work. That means, as a person who expects, as a person who has got his own priority, the parent and the teacher, and the parent and the students, and another person as facilitator, the teacher. When I say the teacher, the school, the management, the principal, everybody all put together, our priorities has got to be the same. It means Krishna became the embodiment of contemplative wisdom. This is primarily because the priority of Krishna and his parents who sent him to the ashram of Sandipani, the guru of Krishna, and the priority of Sandipani, both matched each other. That was the reason why when Krishna as well as Sudhama, they both study in Sandipani Shastram. One was from a royal family, the other fellow was a poor Brahmin. But when it comes to a question of going to study in ashram, both were kept on same plane, same plateau. And both got the same ambition, same priorities. And the result was, Krishna became Yogeshwara Krishnaha, and Sudhama, you know, the greatest character of Sudhama was his sterling character.
Yes.
And the output of Sudhama was, though hemmed in by poverty, he does not stoop to the extent of even going, when he goes and meets Krishna, he does not even ask. He says, my wife has sent me to give me something. And Krishna gives him on his own. His output is...
Thank you so much, sir, for giving your insights. Because somewhere I feel we all need to do some thinking, because so that learning is a lifelong process, so that children do not start thinking that, okay, it's only in school and college and getting marks for which I need to go to school. But schooling and childhood becomes a joyous part of his life. So thank you so much, sir. And I hope together we can all make difference to the way we
yes.
teach our children and to the way
absolutely we right.
teach our children.
Only drops make an ocean. Maybe yes. a little make a big one.